The invisible Toyota pickup I had. What's that?
Whenever I unclick the winch from the tree, the whole tree, like, it bounced around or something.
Oh, yeah, because of the angle that the tree is on. I've done that, too, where you're winching really hard on a tree and it bends over, then you release it, the tree, like, snaps around. Yeah, it just doesn't want to come up out of there. And it's too long of a wheelbase to back up and actually get a run at it.
Yeah.
That little Toyota Hilux that I repurposed there, the one that wasn't showing up, I can get up there by backing up far enough that I can start rolling and then stuff it in high gear and up over that.
Yeah, I had to winch a couple times again,
I've also reworked the torque on that Hilux as well, so...
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. I think the original mod had... the heck, was it around 260,000 newton meters of torque? I upped it to 450,000.
Oh, wow.
I mean, if I put it in automatic or high or something, it moves pretty fast, but usually don't use those gears.
Yeah.
It has enough torque that I can almost start that truck off in high gear, though.
Holy crap. Oh, somebody just took off.
Yeah, this is a faster section of the trail. You can go pretty good along here.
Holy crap, I forgot. Brutes mods, when you put it into high, it gives it a weird turn. Like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like the tires grip up more. So when you turn, it just...
Like the old sideways?
Yeah, like the old school cartoons where you just see the person driving straight and then make a 90 degree left turn within like 3 feet.
Yeah, that Toyota does that to me. Even in high gear, this thing's not overly fast.
No, it's not.
Have to go into automatic.
No, yeah.
Which I like. I hate that when you get the guys that have it modded so that high gear is faster than, like, one plus is faster than top gear and automatic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then I get really irritated with guys who put their one plus speed setting at, like, a whopping 2 miles an hour faster than low three.
Yeah, I very rarely do I use one plus.
The same with me, but whenever you do need it, it's not as fast.
Try that little burst of speed, yeah. You want that little burst of speed to climb a hill, yeah. Yeah, because it's kind of a pain to throw it into automatic, and yeah.
And then half the time you throw it in automatic, it wants to shift gears and hunt and everything like that.
Yeah. And that's the best. Right as you get to the top of the hill, it decides it needs to shift gears and it comes to a dead stop.
Yeah.
You're like, what? I've never had an automatic transmission bring me to a dead stop because it wanted to downshift.
Right.
Spintires has got some strange stuff going on with it, that's for sure.
That's okay, it's literally the one game I play the absolute most of.
Oh, me too. I do a lot of this. If BeamNG ever come out with multiplayer, though, that might change.
Yeah, that could be fun.
Yeah, the soft body physics in that game and the realistic damage to your vehicle, it's a blast. I don't know what's more fun, actually trying to do off-roading or just demolishing the vehicle.
Yeah. What would be awesome is if they did a multiplayer and had like a demo derby.
Oh yeah, you can set up a demo. You could set up a demo derby track. They actually have a couple of race tracks on there too. You can do drift and everything on that.
Oh wow. Which way did you go at the river?
Turn to your left. There you are. I see you.
I don't see you.
Yeah, that's because I've increased the distance that I can see things with the Spintires Plus.
Ah.
I can see your GMC bouncing along the trail there.
Yeah,
your
I
name
got
isn't
up
showing
automatic.
Up yet, but.
Oh, I see you.
Now we get to test the water handling capabilities. Yeah, this is a good river crossing to test it out on. Yeah, nice. No water damage.
Nice. I started into the water at two damage points,
and I will be coming out with two damage points.
No water damage taken there.
Yeah, this is one of my favorite maps for doing, considering it's actually based off a real off-roading park.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Moron lives in Washington.
Mm-hmm.
Over in Washington State, so all his maps are based out of Washington, and this is an actual off-road park. In fact, Whiskey lives about 3 hours from this off-road park.
Huh. That's freaking awesome.
So, yeah, I kind of use Moron as my standard for maps I'm building and the maps that I run, and, you know, when guys upload new maps. If it has enough interest to me to download it, this is kind of the standard I judge it off of. Because this has got a nice degree of difficulty to it without having the really chopped up trails and the crazy off camber corners and stuff like that. And it's nice. It's a scenic map.
Oh yeah, it's very beautiful.
Oh yeah, it's very beautiful.
Except for the dead trees right
there. And
I
think I think that's a, you know, kind of an important thing to do when you're making your map is, you know, not just making crazy trails, but, you know, make it visually appealing as well.
Yeah.
And that's when I did Wild Horse, that's where I really started to focus on it, and that's why my maps are taking a lot longer to make now.
Yeah.
A lot of my earlier maps, I was able to complete them fairly quickly, but the quality wasn't there. I mean, I know people enjoyed them and stuff, but, you know, lots of them are like, well, which one's your favorite? And I always said I haven't made my favorite one yet. Because I hadn't progressed enough as a map maker to create what I expect to see for a map.
Right.
Right.
But once you get up to the point of making maps that are this kind of quality, it takes as much time to do that as it does for a lot of guys to make their modded vehicles.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, I'm in love with this GMC.
Yeah, I'm in love with this GMC.
It's a really nice mod. It's one of my favorites too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, not only that, it has.
If you go to my my content on there, there is a 1980 Chevy you can download that I've done for friends only.
All right.
It's one that I got from the old legacy version of Spintires. Spun knows the original modder, so he's like, yeah, the guy's really, really picky about people reusing his mod, which I'm fine with. You know, he said, he doesn't care if you repurpose it for yourself and your friends, but, you know, not to release it for other people. And that's what I told him. I'm not going to step on people's toes by remaking their mods and releasing them as my own. I don't do that.
Oh, have you seen flood of people stealing mods lately?
Yeah, I've noticed that. I've seen there was one of Spun's K5 Blazer.
Yeah, it's just basically the guy didn't even bother.
Yeah, the guy didn't even bother taking the blue license plate off the front. It was like, really, dude? Seriously?
Then there's, I think somebody took one of Sid's Jeeps. I think that's what I've seen on it.
Like, I have a Spun mod that isn't on the workshop because it's a legacy mod.
Mm-hmm.
91 Ram Charger open top. But I just repurposed it for myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The FJ Cruiser that I put up on the workshop, I had no idea who the original modder is. Because it was an old legacy mod, and I searched around, couldn't find. I found a couple of sites, and it was like, yeah, author is listed as unknown. So it's like, well, you know, I'm tired of waiting for somebody to make one of these. So I just, but I also, you know, put the disclaimer up when I put it up on the workshop. Like, this, I didn't create this mod. This mod is just a conversion from legacy.
Right.
Right.
I've seen a few mods that are on Legacy that I would like to see come into the full game.
It all depends on how old they are, whether conversion is possible or not. If they're like ST-14 Legacy, yeah, there's a good chance they can be converted, but if they're older than that, then it gets a little dicey.
Ah.
Because I have a few that I can convert over. But they're, like I said, they're Spun's mods, so I figure he's eventually going to release them anyways, because that's what those guys have been doing. Like, he did a really nice little Suzuki Samurai.
There's one of the few times that the long wheelbase is beneficial for off-roading.
I didn't have any problems with the Jeep. It just crawled right up that. Imagine you're getting to where you need some fuel now.
No, actually, I'm pretty good. I've got 847 out of 1,000.
Oh, yeah, right. I forgot. He gave a ridiculous amount of fuel.
Yeah. Well, almost every single mod is a ridiculous amount of fuel.
Well, it has to be because of their fuel consumption thing. In order for it to be kind of realistic, like that Hilux that I redid, I set it to a 90-liter tank. Figured, yeah, let's try it with a 90-liter tank. Well, you don't get very far on 90 liters.
No. And when you look at it, 90 liters is actually on the high end of what a fuel tank should be.
Yeah.
That'd be like, what, a 35, 40-gallon tank for like a full-size diesel?
I don't think it'd be quite that big. 205 liters is 45 gallons, so.
Okay.
Okay.
So, yeah, you're probably looking at, like, a 25-gallon tank, maybe?
So what I put in my,
my
25, 28 gallons, perhaps? Yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't sure which tank, my truck had. So I just went and bought the smaller one, because, you know, it's cheaper. Eh, I got the wrong one technically for what the truck had, but they both fit.
Yeah, the one thing I like about that is you got the old carbureted 350. I grew up on carburetors, so.
Actually, mine is the electronic fuel injection.
Really mine. Is it? It looked like it was carbureted.
It's the throttle body injection.
Oh, okay.
Which essentially, you know, is a carburetor with just two fuel injectors spraying the fuel instead of jets dripping the fuel.
Yeah. I don't know. It all depends on how you tune your carburetor.
Yeah.
I've rebuilt a lot of carburetors in my time, so.
Well, I was afraid because it had sat for 4 years.
I'm kind of a fan of carbureted engines.
Yeah, I am too.
Yeah. Yeah, it is a little bit spooky when it sits out for that long because of the fuel, and you know, fuel doesn't have a very good shelf life.
No, but no, my biggest fear was that
it varnishes up the injectors, and yeah.
Well, I had looked around because I was afraid of that happening. The injectors getting varnished up.
Varnished up.
They're expensive.
They're expensive
for that truck.
Oh, yeah.
There was, I think, $200 per injector. It's like, I can go get a carburetor and the adapter plate to run a carburetor on that truck for a lot cheaper than that.
This is a tricky little area to get through. You'll have to watch your footing going through here. Especially Brutes mods, they seem to be a tad on the top heavy side.
Yeah, I've noticed that before.
I can't even run his 98 Durango. The only reason I keep his 98 Durango around is because I robbed the tires off of it for other mods that I tweak for running this.
Ah.
Because those tires are perfect for a lot of mods.
Huh. Yeah, whenever I had that mod on or downloaded, it would crash my game every single time I tried to run it.
I had a lot of issues when I uploaded that FJ Cruiser. First off, I had stuff that wasn't showing up. I had to redo a lot of the image files. And then, suspension tuning and tires. A lot of weird stuff going on with those.
Yeah.
And I basically had to work for majority of people, I had to take out any of the Spintires Plus coating that was in there governing the suspension and the tires. So it could have been that his Spintires Plus coating on for his tires may have been causing new issues.
It's possible.
Yeah, I grew up on carburetors myself, so I prefer carburetors.
Actually, the vehicles I've had that lasted the longest were the older vehicles. I had a 92 Oldsmobile 88 that had the Gen 1 3800. I drove that thing for 4 years, put probably 150,000 miles on it in the 4 years. And it was sold to a dealership running. Let's see, I had an 84 Ranger that I had for like a year and a half, 2 years in high school that I beat the ever-living piss out of it.
84 Ranger in high school. That's You're not, you can't be that much younger than me then.
No, well, 80. Nope. The truck was the same age as me, so.
Well, I guess it all depends on when you went to high school then.
Yeah.
I would have been 14 when that truck came off the assembly line.
Alright. So, that puts you at 14 years older than me.
14 years older than me.
Ah, gotcha.
The one old truck that I had that I missed the most was my 77 F-150. Granted,
actually,
it was only a two-wheel
trucks...
drive. Oh, what was that?
Of all the trucks I've had that I missed the most, I had the newer body style 2007 Silverado 1500 crew cab. That truck was amazing.
Huh.
The 5.3 liter?
Oh, yeah.
I get a lot of arguments from people over this. They didn't have the advanced fuel management system on that engine. They did. In 2007, they absolutely did. People don't realize that. I was getting... If I stayed at the speed limit, used my cruise control, and drove smart, I was getting, 28, 29 miles to the gallon with that truck.
Holy crap.
Oh, it blew me away how nice that truck was. And the best riding truck I've ever owned. It was so smooth.
Yeah.